Player? Ready? Hey everybody, welcome to the show. I'm A Bit Here. We're gonna be playing The Park, an independent horror game. Came out in October 2015. The same guys made Secret World MMO. It's about a lady who loses her son inside of a haunted or disturbing amusement park. Other than that, I don't know much more about it. Take 37, action! Here we go, everybody! New game. Let me know if there's any audio changes I need to make. Otherwise, let's do this. I'm ready. I'm kind of disturbed that it manipulates graphics and audio control settings. I don't want you touching those things, Park. Is it going to slowly ramp its volume up for the scary parts? Is that what it's... That's some fuckery.
In my heart and mind, I always return to Atlantic Island Park.
It's kind of weird they do this opening.
I haven't seen black bars. Tell him. Stay in the car. Go and ask information.
And then it snaps the black bars out. Game goes super quiet. You pause. Entire menu is reversed in Gaelic. How's the audio on the game? Does it need to come up a bit? I feel like it needs to go up a bit before we get anywhere good. Before we go anywhere other than the parking lot of Atlantic Island Park, where they have bingo.
Attention patrons, the park is now closed. Please make your way to the car park at your earliest convenience.
Well, park's closed.
Prepare the park for shutdown.
Audio seems fine now. Okay. If it needs to go up, just let me know. I'll give it a quick... Press A to interact with objects in the world. Examine plaque.
Callum was born the day this place opened. This is his favorite place in the world.
Atlantic Island Park, a tribute to the untamed heart of Solomon Island and the people who use their talents to bring the dream of Nathaniel Winter to life. May this park be a place where joy and laughter are gathered and used to infect all those who follow after. Dedicated this first day of May 1977, James B. Longley. Increase it one more notch. Alright. Settings. Audio. It goes... Wait a minute. It goes from 5 to 7. There is no one... There is no one more notch, Medic. From this quality game. It's two or nothing. Alright, back to the game. You're gonna have to take two and you're gonna have to like it. Hello? I mean, I wear your clothes, but there should probably be somebody at the ticket booth to do, like, returns or... Wow, those clouds are even creepy. Oh, here we go. Tickets.
What?
Well, that's not good.
Hey, Lorraine. Lorraine. Don't blame yourself, Lorraine. People lose things all the time. Take a deep breath. Think about the last place you saw your son's teddy bear. Hey, stop! I think your boy just ran into the park. I'll unlock the gates for you.
And then he's immediately sitting down? Alright, hold on. I'm calling it right now. The kid never went into the park. He's over in the car still. Hold on. I gotta go check this out for my own disbelief here. this lady has the slowest walk cycle in all of history. Hello? Is he in here? Oh, no. He ran inside. Or was kidnapped and raped. One of the two. There's no other reasonable, so it has to be one of those two. It's either kidnapping or in raping, and or he went into the theme park. Definitely wouldn't go get a soda or go to the bathroom. Any of those options. Press B to shout. Shouting provides audible and visual clues to guide you.
Callum, where are you going?
Come on, Mommy!
Okay, that was kind of weird. Got like a bird's eye thing on the flyer here. Atlantic Island Park. Welcome to Atlantic Island Park. When I first came to visit Solomon Island, I fell deeply in love with its natural beauty. It's a scenic place, and I created many of my best memories here. I wanted to create a place that captures the essence of Solomon Island. Place where families would bring their children to create memories of their own. I invite you to explore this park that we've created from the Ferris wheel, which rivals the local lighthouse with the best views in the area, to the slideshow alley, where we have the fascinating games and objects from the local area to explore. Enjoy, Nathaniel Winter. Chad the Chipmunk recommends for the little ones try the Tunnel of Tales for a Seattle family-friendly retelling of timeless fairy tales. If that sounds a little too slow, grab an adult and jump on the bumper cars. Full throttle fun for everyone. Teens, pump up your adrenaline by going through a spin cycle on the Octotron. Then defy the laws of gravity on an award-winning roller coaster. Finish it all up with the House of Horrors. But be warned, it might scare all the fun out of you. For the big ones, take a romantic spin on the Ferris wheel with your significant other and take in the natural beauty of Solomon Island. Followed up with a stroll through the exotic exhibits and wild games at Slideshow Alley. There's truly something for everybody at Atlantic Island Park. Drink bingo! Once you left the park, there's still so much to do in Solomon Island. Present this brochure to local businesses, save big money. Place to eat Sunshine Deli, Susie's Diner, The Lobster Trap, sleep at Overlook Motel, Jack and Wendy's Bed and Breakfast. Alrighty. There's that little bastard now! Beat the shit out of this kid.
About the entrance to an amusement park. A line drawn between the real world and the world of whimsy within. On this side, the apathy of our everyday lives. And on the other, anything we might dare to dream. It's no wonder Callum ran back inside. I wouldn't want to leave either.
Attention employees, the park is now closed. Have a safe journey home.
That's a safety issue right there. Wait a minute, why is it suddenly getting so rapidly dark? Hello? What the fuck, they only have an on-off switch for the sun? Well fuck that, let me back out. No thank you. He can stay in there, fuck that. God, I gotta crank up the sensitivity, guys. Hold on. That's gonna drive me nuts. If I have to fucking turn around fast, I am gonna literally... There we go. There we go. Back and continue, please. Alright. How's that? There we go.
Oh, God. The park. What happened here?
Press R1 to toggle running. Oh, she's not much of a runner, is she?
You can't catch me.
Fuck that! I don't
Wait
want him.
Mommy.
Really?
Callum, where did you go?
Oh, fuck all that down there. No, thank you. Can we at least take a nap? Where are we?
Don't hide from me, Callum.
Alright, entrance. Sideshow alleys to the right. He's heading right towards the House of Horrors. Little bastard. You wait till I catch you, I'm gonna strangle your ass.
Hello?
Catch me, Mommy.
I'm gonna catch you, I'm gonna beat the shit out of you, kid. Nah, I'm good. There's the House of Horrors. We'll just be right past that. Carrie Killian is Satan's whore.
Wait for Mommy.
Over here.
Catch up with this little bastard.
Callum, stay where you are.
This way, Mommy.
All right, he's going down in the fairy tale. Examine shoe.
I think this belongs to Callum.
You don't know? You bought it. It's not like he went to the shoe store and bought his own damn shoes. What'd she do with it? Just stuck it in her pocket? Okay. Who's this little guy?
The chipmunk, huh? Just a drunk guy in a suit.
Just a drunk guy in a suit. Chad can be seen daily ice sculpting shows in the following locations. 11 a.m. Sideshow Alley. 1 p.m. The Octatron. And 3 p.m. The Park Entrance. Chad the Chipmunk. Worst in class. Chad can't even seem to pass. Chad gets angry. Likes to fight. Chad is beaten every night. Chad will have a dead-end job. Chad will die a useless slob. Somebody not like Chad.
Callum, tell Mommy where you are.
Come on, this way.
What the hell is that? Read handwritten
note. What's
this? Purchase the land of Solomon Island for a pittance. Might add, whatever old Archie Henderson did to the locals, just the mention of his name had people slamming doors and locking shutters from the moment I arrived on the island. My lawyers had arranged everything in advance, but the realtor still had come and deliver the keys to me personally. He took it upon himself to offer me another warning. I don't know what you're planning to do with this land, Mr. Winter, but the soil here is bitter with a curse carried from the old country. Old Man Henderson, he did terrible dark things, and the land remembers, sir. I dismissed him shortly afterwards, mostly amused by his pathetic attempts at warding me off. I have a great vision for this place, and the will to see this vision through to the very end. Atlantic Island Park. The name is perfect, and I cannot imagine it being anything else. This is the start of something amazing.
Come out, sweetie.
This way.
Bathrooms.
Come to Mommy, Callum.
Hello? Nope.
Callum, where are you?
We're at the Tunnel of Tales.
Come on, Mommy.
Is he on the ride?
Callum, stay where you are.
Oh, you little bat. Come here. Oh, no. That's just a
stop,
small.
Callum.
Did he take one? Uh-oh. Wanna ride the swan? Well, all you, I guess. Wait, who's operating this ride if it's closed right now? Is that a camera?
great forest, there lived a poor woodcutter, his wife and his two children. A boy named Hansel and a girl named Gretel. They were very poor and had very little to bite or sup.
Bite or sup?
What will become of us? The woodcutter asked his wife one night. I tell you what, husband. We will take the children into the thickest part of the forest tomorrow and abandon them there. No, my wife. I cannot do that, said the man. Then we will all four starve, you fool. Hansel and Gretel overheard their parents talking, and Gretel began
Wait, did she just offer to leave the children in the woods?
Do not fret, Gretel, Hansel said. He crept out of the hut and gathered white stones from the ground to fill his pockets. The next morning, the woodcutter leads the children into the forest. Before they leave, their mother gives them a slice of bread and warns them that they will get no more food that day.
Oh, fuck that.
Clever
oh, shit.
Leaves a trail of white stones behind them as they pass into the woods. When their father leaves them, the children wait a while, then follow the trail back to their parents' house.
Oh, no. Fuck, I can't see
After
it anymore.
After receiving a thorough scolding from their parents for getting lost in the woods, the children are sent to bed without any supper. Hansel tried to sneak out and collect more white stones, but found that the door was locked. Tomorrow I will take them into the woods myself, the wife told the woodcutter. In the morning, their mother gave them a slice of bread and led them deep into the forest once again.
Hello?
Hansel broke his bread into pieces and left a trail of breadcrumbs to lead them safely home. But hungry-eyed birds snatched up the breadcrumbs and his trail was destroyed. Abandoned by their parents and unable to find the trail home, the children wandered in the forest.
I'm fucking I want to watch the story, but at the same time, Uh-oh. Something's in the water. God
the children
it.
Stumbled into a clearing
Don't
with an
do that amnesia shit
strange
to me.
House. Its walls were made of gingerbread, and its windows were panes of clear sugar. Hansel, desperately hungry, ran forward and began to nibble on the walls. Old woman emerged from the house.
This is a good story to tell along with a horror game.
Peering around with cloudy eyes. Oh, you dear children, who brought you here? Just come in and stay with me. No harm will come to you. But Hansel and Gretel stayed back, for the old woman reminded them of their cruel mother. Come, children, don't be afraid. I have something for you. The old woman offered them two enormous lollipops. The children took them and began to eat. You see, nothing to fear here. Come inside, the old woman urged, and the children, still licking their sweets, followed.
Uh-oh.
Once inside the house, the old woman changed. She stuffed Hansel into a cage and put Gretel to work, sweeping and cleaning her hut. Your brother...
I don't know what the fuck I'm going to do if something attacks me. I'm stuck on the boat.
Told Gretel, once he is fattened up, I shall feast upon him. Time passed, and poor Hansel refused to eat, fearing the day that the witch would eat him. The witch, for her part, grew impatient. Today, I will cook and eat your brother, Gretel. Climb inside and light the oven. But Gretel pretended not to understand.
Dad, we're almost to the end of the tunnel.
I do not know how. Where is the opening?
There's no way, it's just a peaceful swan ride the whole way through.
The witch said, the opening is here. And she moved to show Gretel. Seizing her courage, brave Gretel gave the witch a shove, and the old crone tumbled forward into the oven. Gretel slid a large iron bolt over the door to the oven. Gretel freed her brother Hansel.
Yes, demon, she does still stream.
They lit a fire beneath
she is sick currently.
And though she screamed and begged, the children sat by the oven until her screams had stilled, and the witch was cooked.
And they ate her! Yay, the end.
And then, because even children can't survive on sweets, they divided up the body of the old witch and ate her.
Yes. Okay. Well, that was... Okay, I would like off now. I would like off now, please. Thanks, Mr. Swan. You just stay right the hell over there. Thanks, buddy. That was fun.
Please, Callum, tell me where you are!
Hansel and Gretel. I used to read it to Callum when the electricity was shut off. Those poor children. The whole world against them. The forest, the birds, the old witch, even their own parents. I used to imagine that Callum and I were the kids in that story. Not mother and son, but brother and sister, hand in hand against the unkind world.
And then you eat the witch at the end?
Always hungry, looking for our own house made of candy. Looking for the sweetness that could take the pain away. Hunger leads people to desperate, terrible places where the tree branches reach like claws.
Okay, well.
Where did you go?
Hello?
Hello?
Where's over here?
Where are you?
It's getting nice and weird, just the way I like it.
Callum?
Here we go. Oh, he's in the van.
Another accident.
That's where I keep all my children. Park maintenance. Hello? Jesus. Hey, there's the teddy bear. Despite the constant interruptions to work, Atlantic Island Park will be opening on time. The governor is booked to cut the ribbon, so the only real question is whether we will have any customers. Not really worried, the customers will come out of simple curiosity. Sorry, what was needed from the banned writings of Archie Hudson? It's astonishing to think that a resident's positive emotions could be used to fuel such a process. Henderson himself chose to use negative, and that caused some of the taint that still lingers in this place. I will not make his mistakes. Very soon, I will know if it has all been for nothing. Oh, the teddy bear's gonna... knife in his eye. That's nice. I'll just leave that there. Can I open this door? No? I kind of want the knife more than anything. No? Okay. Well, that's nice.
Callum!
Who the hell names your kid Callum? When I catch you, you little bastard, I'm gonna strangle you. My kid ran off the park like this, I'd beat the shit out of him.
Callum?
I'm following the trail, but... I feel like I'm in, this game has a very Spirited Away type feel to it. Beat the shit out of him anyways. Oh, it's the octopus ride. I'm just not a fan of kids.
Where are you?
Oh yeah, that's gonna not make me throw up. Let me guess. We gotta ride all the rides, don't we? Son of a bitch, bastard! Beat this kid to death.
This old thing used to make the blood run to my head. It'd make me dizzy.
Examine report.
The guy just snapped. Those poor kids.
Eyewitness report from Atlantic Island Park incident. Officer on duty, Sheriff F. Bannerman. Witness name, Norma Creed. Statement, we were waiting for our turn on the ride. Frank, me, and the boys. This fellow in the chipmunk suit is making an ice carving while people took photographs. Lawrence wanted to go over him, but I've always been a bit wary of those suits. They gave me the creeps. It's silly, I know. Anyway, the chipmunk man, he was carving and picking away at the ice. At first we thought he was making some animal, like a tiger or lion, but as more and more ice fell away, when you first looked, it was like a human face smiling out of that block of ice. But the more you looked at it, the more you saw there was something not quite right about the proportions. Just something unnatural that made your heart begin to beat a little faster, like you were prey that thing was ice was hunter. Then these teenagers walk up, one of them made a face at the carving and said something rude to the guy in the chipmunk suit, and well then, he went berserk. For a few moments, it was chaos. Everybody was running away from the guy who had one of the teenagers on the ground, and he was stabbing with the ice pick, and blood was spraying, and people were screaming, and Frank and I had the kids, and we were dragging them away as fast as we could. And the last thing I saw before Frank dragged me away was the eyeball of one of those poor kids that landed on the ice sculpture, making the horrible creature look more or less alive. Do you want to know what time Lav streams? She streams from 7 o'clock to 10 o'clock. And she does that Monday through Friday, although she is currently sick at the moment, so... Alright, where the hell is the entrance for this thing? Hello?
I'm not playing anymore, Callum.
Well, the bridge is broken.
Callum!
Frustrated by the fact that the plans seem incomplete. I know as well as anybody that the rules of the game can be changed with enough money. But no matter how much money talks, it can't conjure up missing plans from thin air. Tried contacting the organization who sold me these plans, and they're stonewalling me. Every contact that I had, every meeting place that I have washed, are swept bare. I have a sinking feeling that I've been swindled. We've gone ahead with what we could find, the plans regardless, harvesting machines, the transport mechanisms, etc. I'll probably let Nicholas name them something cute for the day we open the park. They will be rides, after all.
Callum, come back here right now!
Where'd this little bastard go?
Callum? Where'd you go?
shit. Time to ride the ride. Okay. Must be this tall to ride it. Well,
I can't get on while it's moving.
Oh, I have to control my own ride. Great. There we go. Well, how are we gonna start it up? And how the hell are we gonna get off later? Well, I mean, I guess we just roll sideways into the water. No, fuck that. Mm-mm. Oh, shit. I don't know what the fuck that was, but nope. This would be terrible to, like, for a fucking virtual reality game. My God. Whew. Is something in the booth? Oh, fuck. Something's in the booth. Oh, no. Where's the jump button? Because I'm not walking by that shit. No, thank you. Where'd it go?
Where'd you go? Mommy needs to see you, Callum. Come out, sweetie.
It's kind of telling me, like, right here where I'm at.
Wait, Callum. Oh, I remember this.
God, what a face that is! Alright, am I doing it right? That's how I take all my photos.
Come out, sweetie. Callum!
Okay, I heard it in my headset. It's over to the right.
Where are you?
Treachery hides in thoughts. Treachery that lashes like a whip and scars our insides. First time I saw Callum.
What are we, like a slam poetry meeting?
I looked down at this wrinkled, red, bawling thing and I thought, is that it? We build our world from expectations, and the world that I had built for Callum was no different. He was so real, so there, and so far from my expectations. And they shattered, and as they fell in pieces, that one treacherous thought became a new foundation. All of the love that we shared, all of the warmth and goodness that followed, built on a single, traitorous thought.
What the fuck is in the window? It's got bunny ears on. You guys see that, right?
Come back, Callum.
Hold on. Thank you. There's something in there. There ain't enough fucking money you can pay me to open that door. It ain't happening. God, I gotta read this page while looking in there? Oh, Jesus. I thought working in the park for summer would be a lot of fun, but the end of the season here really drags. There aren't that many tourists, and so most of the staff spend their days standing around gossiping. And most of that gossip is about Chad. I mean, Steve? See? Even though I'm starting to call him Chad, and I went to school with a guy. It's a goddamn suit. In the beginning, it was a laugh. Steve, the local lush, B.S. Chad, the chipmunk. Child-friendly mascot, Atlantic Island Park. Lock up your daughters and all that. But the more he wears the suit, the weirder Steve is getting. First, there was little things, like refusing to change up the suit at work or taking it home with him every day. But then I saw him at Susie's diner, still wearing it.
Tales of our endeavors proliferate.
Thank you guys so much for the host. I know what you're doing. You're trying to... face check and roll while you won't. First was little things like refusing to change out of the suit at work, taking it home with every day. Then I saw him at Susie's diner still wearing it. And it wasn't even a work day. Some of the staff complained discreetly to the park manager about the smell. And I saw him walking and talking with Mr. Winter, the owner, one day. But nothing seems to have changed. The suit still smells like a carcass whenever Steve walks by. And apparently Steve has picked up some new skills since the last time I saw him. Puking up in the gutter outside the sick coil station, because he sure as hell can carve a mean ice sculpture. Those shapes he makes in the ice, though, they give me the creeps. Steve came by the booth today, lucky me, just hung around for a little while. Couldn't really tell because of the suit, but it seemed like he was just staring at me, sizing me up, eye fucking me, whatever he's doing. I asked him what he wanted to do, and he just stood there, not saying anything. Eventually, I called my supervisor. When he came by, Steve, wandered off. Supervisor told me to put everything in writing, so here it is. Also, I quit. I don't see that chipmunk suit ever again. Signed, Laura.
Mommy needs to see you.
Fuck! God! Oh, Jesus! Fucking heart just left in my chest. It's a little warm in here. Holy shit, Snacks. Fuck that. What else you got?
Callum?
Fuck, my hands are shaking now.
Come out, sweetie.
I'm gonna kill you, you bastard. By the way, this game has spooks.
Callum, stay where you are. Where are you?
Bumper cars? What do I think of the game so far? It's good, Devlin. This would make the perfect VR game. Just heads up, don't want you to get too scared.
Come back, Callum. Constant crashes and 80s music. Guess it floats someone's boat.
Alright, well... this one's off the track. That's kind of unusual. Yeah, because apparently I know how to repair these, right? What the fuck?
Thank you.
Yeah, it was a bitch to get running. And its option menu is laughable at best.
Hello?
Stop, Doctor, stop. Electroshock therapy?
Don't hide from me, Callum. Callum, tell Mommy where you are.
It's gonna be an M. Night Shyamalan ding-dong twist ending. Either that or she's the squirrel. Did you ride on the twirly ride? Yes, yes, I rode on the twirly ride.
Where are you?
I almost shit myself. Whoa. Oh no, that's just the steering wheel. At this point, I'm shit for dead, right?
Callum. I'm not playing anymore, Callum.
Examine accident report. Employee name, Francis Dufresne. Laborers working on the crane. Richard Stapleton, witness. Lawrence Creed, Michael Edgeworth. Brief description of the accident or incident. During the transport of the bumper cars into the arena, one of the straps attaching the load to the truck came untied, causing a cascade of bumper cars onto Francis, who was standing directing the driver. Francis was crushed by the weight of the cars. Describe any injuries. Francis is dead. Did the injured employee see a doctor? Yes. Did you file employee's portion of workers' comp form? Yes. Supervisor comment. How did he see the doctor if he was dead? Dexter, the trucker driver, claims that he saw someone on the back of the load undoing the straps. Nobody else reported seeing that. The sheriff has requested that Dexter provide him with urine samples. Could have been done to prevent the accident incident. Double checking of the straps after transit should be mandatory in drug screenings for all drivers. Have the unsafe conditions been corrected? Yes? No. No. The local laborers are very superstitious, and this hasn't helped. Some of them are refusing to return to work until we have someone from the local church walk the park and exorcise the bad spirits. We're just gonna have to take his license away. This one's got... I got my own headlights. Can I not drive that one?
Mommy is coming, Callum.
What happened with this guy over here? Anybody else need poop for their pants? They got plenty to spare. Ew, gross, it's a baby.
Mommy is coming, Callum. Callum, where did you go?
Yeah, let's walk towards the crying baby. That, nothing'll go wrong. Oh. Apparently, she's silent as the wind in footsteps up metal stairs.
It's a matter of public record that I am a failure as a mother. Once, when Callum was very small, I left him asleep in the car while I ran an errand. Don't even remember what it was. When I came back, the sheriff was standing next to the car, watching my boy through the window.
Pervert.
Didn't like what I saw in his eyes. Judgment. He wrote me the ticket without saying a word. Just the scratch of his pen on the notepad. When he gave it to me, our eyes met. I know what you're going through. My daughter, Helen, she... just gets some help. Help was a bolt of lightning. Help was 1,000 volts surging through my veins. Help is agony. I'd rather die. I wanted to scream. I'd rather you pulled your gun and shot me. But instead my mouth said, yes, Sheriff.
Stay where you are.
I don't do heights. Fuck that. I don't. The Ferris wheel is like probably the scariest thing ever for me. Is an actual like carnival ride, or like going to an amusement park. I'll do 1,000 roller coasters, but fuck the Ferris wheel. Where's that baby crying from?
Callum, where did you go?
That's an obscenely large Ferris wheel, right? That thing broke down at the top and I was on it, I'd just fucking put a gun in my mouth, providing it had one. Continually delayed by the incompetence of the builders, the problem is that they are locals, and so they believe a lot of the rumors about what old man Henderson used to do here, they grew up on those tales. Every time a bolt comes loose or a wrench goes missing, those fools are crossing themselves against the black magic. Of course, that's why I chose this site over all other potential. Solomon Island is a nexus for dark energies, and the thought of all that power dissipating beneath the earth here makes my skin crawl. I called a few favors back in Brooklyn and got someone at the local academy to see if they had any interest in books about local history. Turns out they do, and it turns out that old man Henderson has some pretty strong connections in the Brooklyn crowd. Perhaps something that he wrote will help me find the piece of the plans that I'm missing. Hey, Freddy! Doc, what's going on, buddy? You guys are just in time for the good stuff.
Where are you, Callum?
They won't meet it. No opening? I already read that.
Where are you, Callum? Stay where you are!
Fucking hell! It's lighting up the Ferris wheel. For me to ride. I don't want to ride any more rides, okay?
Callum? Callum?
Oh, fuck.
Callum? Tell Mommy where you are.
Okay. So, slow it down.
Stay where you are.
Time to ride the Ferris wheel. Fuck it, fucker. Again, thank God I don't have my VR headset. Shit myself right now. Still might happen.
Our community grows.
Freddy, thank you so much for becoming a hero today. Appreciate it. Welcome to 12-hour stream. Oh boy. Okay, this ain't so bad. Oh, I haven't started going up yet. Okay, well, that's...
People come into your life for a reason.
Alrighty, enough looking down. Ran off.
After that, he mostly just drank. Things were different for Don and I. When we met, I was sweeping the floor at Susie's diner. He came in with some workers, but he didn't try to flirt or cop a feel like the others. He just ordered a coffee and sat there, watching me. When my shift was over, he offered to walk me home. I don't know how to describe that walk. We talked and laughed and eventually kissed. It felt like love. It felt like a fairy tale. I can't tell you if Callum was made that night or one of the ones that followed. But I think it has to be that night. That one perfect night. Don and I moved in together, but then, well, he died.
What do you mean he died?
According to the supervisor, his safety harness failed when he was working on the top of the Ferris wheel. Don was there one moment, and then gone. Sometimes people leave your life for no reason. I was 3 months pregnant with Callum. Fairy tale fucking over.
Okay, well, they should really put like a safety bar or something on this thing. I don't know about you guys. I'm ready to get off now. I know, stuttering intensifies, right? I don't know what the hell this thing's... thing's shaky as shit. But I'm ready to come... Alright, something's in the booth. That's cool. I still want off it. Alright, so her husband used to work... on the Ferris wheel, and he died one day when the safety strap gave out on him.
Where are you, Callum? Don't be afraid.
He wants me to go in here.
So they are going to close this place down. Doesn't surprise me.
Inspection date, September 22nd, 1980. Unsafe, close the park. Inspector comments, after touring the park, riding the rides, and viewing the startling number of incidents suffered here in the park, it is the inspector's opinion that the Atlantic Island Park should be shut down until Nathaniel Winter complies with all safety regulations. While I understand there is a sensitive political relationship between Mr. Winter and the senator, I nevertheless suggest that such political considerations be set aside in condemning Atlantic Island Park. The rides, at first glance, appear well-constructed and maintained, but the sheer number of incidents in the park during the last few years and during construction lead me to believe there is something wrong at the base level of construction, and we should close the park to fully investigate these flaws. To wit, here is a partial list of fatalities in the park since opening only 2 years ago. 1. Family of three killed when a roller coaster cart derailed. 14 separate incidents of broken bones and crushed ribs while riding the Octotron. 3 suicides from the top of the Ferris wheel. A child seriously injured on the escalator. Someone was killed on that, hurt on the escalator? Jesus. Over a dozen children reported missing in the House of Horrors since its construction. That's good. And one report of a drowning in the Tunnel of Tales. Sheer volume of incidents means it is my strongest recommendation that the Atlantic Island Park be closed immediately. Signed, David Woolsonth. The inspector. Hello?
Mommy is coming, Callum.
You want to just kind of give me a general direction to go in game? Calling a skeleton a Chad. Stole so many lives, became a lich.
Mommy is coming, Callum.
Alright, well. Let's get a run on. Let's go for a run.
Callum, where did you go?
Maybe this way? Gotta hit the whole park? Shouting, I'm not seeing anything.
Stay where you are.
Here we go. Oh, this is a piece of the Ferris wheel. So a roller coaster ticket. Hey, thanks for clearing the path, I guess. That doll's kind of creepy. Eyeballs intensify. See, that kind of shit doesn't scare me, but... like the letter earlier about shit myself.
A lot of people idolize their children. You hear them talking about their kids and just the way they talk, their fucking voices make me want to vomit. My angel likes to read, and little Johnny is so good on the piano. Fuck those people! You give up 9 months of your life carrying them, you traumatize yourself giving birth to them, and then you spend the rest of your life as their slave. Wiping asses, mopping up piss, feeding them, little life-sucking monsters who take and take and take until... we all go insane. Any parent who pretends otherwise is just dishonest.
Mommy had a breakdown.
Choice supportive bias. I am honest. Callum really grinds my gears, and he owes me everything. Everything. It'd serve the little fuck right if I just abandoned him.
Serve him right if I lift his ass here. I'm on board with that idea. He's watching you. Who's... Who's watching me?
Stay where you are!
Mm-mm. Oh boy. Time to ride the roller coaster, eh?
Callum, where did you go?
Don't do it, Mommy.
Don't do what? Behind you. Okay. Just checking.
Mommy is coming, Callum.
Saying he's coming. Every time we say I'm coming.
Where are you, Callum?
Hello? Where'd you go, you little shit? All right, who wants to ride the roller coaster? I'm all for skipping it. Again, fear heights. Not my strong suit.
Callum, tell Mommy where you are.
Cause we could just totally just keep on trucking up the trail. I'd be all right with that.
Where are you, Callum?
You want to ride it? Roller coaster! Oh, love!
Ride this one. Never got around to do it before.
Oh, I don't imagine this is... Well, it will be memorable for you, I'm sure, lady, but... Not the exact ride that you were planning on. Man. Roller coaster! Oh, love! Well, how are we going to get this thing started if there's no one operating? Oh, Mr. Ghosty Goo, could you come press the start button, please? Oh yeah, this looks incredibly safe, by the way. Unoperated in the last 35 years, full of rust, one cart left here. Where's all the other ones? On the track, abandoned somewhere? Fine.
What do you want?
Oh, fuck.
About Callum.
Uh-oh. There's a hand behind me.
I? That's insulting. You and your boy are everything that this place doesn't want. The antithesis of what we stand
for.
Oh,
fuck. It's right behind us in the back seat.
He tried so hard to do what he was taught. He even left you a trail of breadcrumbs. But the park is just so hungry.
Oh, no.
Tell me where my son is.
The witch has him now. Has both of you. No happy ending here, I'm afraid.
Just leave me alone.
Man.
Fool. You always were.
Oh, boy. Oh, no. What does it say? It's gotta be in relation to her going to the mental hospital. shit! I can taste your dreams! Uh-oh! Oh! RIP! Please exit the sidecar. And the captain, please enjoy your ride and the rest of your stay at the park today. Let me guess. Nobody in the back seat with me this time? Well, it works! The calculations adjustments work. The transport and storage mechanisms seem to be flawless. What a wonderful day. If only these people knew what they were fueling. And so what if a few people leave the park at the end of the day feeling down? Or feeling dour? So what if the children are more scared than excited on the roller coaster? This could be the doorway to immortality. And such doorways open only to those who have the will to find the key. Chick's about to have a full-on mental breakdown. See, I don't like the windows. Oh, they're... I was excited that I was getting a flashlight for a moment, and then I realized that's just to unlock more scares for me by throwing me into the dark.
Callum!
God damn it. Typical horror flashlight. The witch awaits. Well,
I can help you, Callum.
Can we... clicking into the... Okay, so the flashlight's gonna be automatic? Holding my breath so goddamn hard there.
Callum, where are you?
Alright, how the hell do we get out of here? Here we go.
Callum has bruises on his arms. Finger marks? Someone has been hurting him.
You!
I asked him, demanded really, to know where he got the marks. But he doesn't want to answer me. Something has scared him into silence. He doesn't dare talk. He's been changing too. Something sinister lurks in the darkness behind his eyes. I catch him staring at me at odd moments. In the night, he tosses and turns and cries out words that I cannot understand. When I try to soothe him, he snaps and bites at my fingers. I think he wants to talk to me. I think he wants to tell me. They are watching him every minute of every day. They are whispering to him in his sleep, changing him. They are taking my baby away from me.
Yeah.
I can't save him. There will be pain. But I love him, and in the end, he will understand why.
Yeah, okay, so she's the one hurting him, more than likely. Fucking hell. If I remember correctly, according to the map, there's only one attraction left, right? The House of Horrors? Oh, no, the alley. Yeah, the slideshow alley, and then... then the House of Horrors. Good. That'd be good. Oh, clowns! Awesome.
Come back!
What are you scared of?
Well, happy clowns for starters, puppets, heights. I have many fears. Don't you do the turning on the light shit after I'm done reading. I'm ready.
The whole town was shocked by that one. Never found out who did it.
Yesterday evening, visitors to Atlantic Island Park were shocked and horrified by the discovery of a dismembered corpse behind the cotton candy stand. According to local authorities, the corpse is yet to be identified. However, they have confirmed that the remains appear to be those of a child. The corpse was discovered by a group of teenagers from Innsmouth Academy who noticed a pair of ravens tugging at something just out of sight behind the shack. Nathaniel Winter, the owner of Atlantic Island Park, has released the following statement. It is a true tragedy when something like this occurs, especially in a place that was designed to bring forth happiness and joy. The staff of Atlantic Island Park offer their condolences to the family and friends of the victims. We'll cooperate fully with the authorities to help bring this case to rest. Solomon Chronicle will provide daily updates on this story going forward. Why did it have to be clowns, right? What the fuck's that noise? Okay. I'm fine.
Callum! Callum!
Mommy, I'm scared.
Hey, you know what? Scary ass fucking like killer clowns? It doesn't bother me as bad. Happy clowns? I'm gonna have a goddamn heart attack.
I can help you, Callum.
Follow the breadcrumbs.
That's the cotton candy booth. Pickled punks. Okay, nothing back here. We're okay. Okay. Murder behind the cotton candy booth of a young boy, eh? I don't do clowns. Oh, it's a child. I'm okay as long as... Don't let that fucking thing... If that thing pops up, I swear I'm gonna lose my shit.
Bastard. Who did this to him?
Don't fuck with me, clown. Oh. Hey, fun fact, I can't back up. Tried to back up, and I knew it was there. Something was there. I knew!
I'm not playing anymore, Callum! Callum? Callum!
Wackajack! I play that all the time. I have no way I'm going by that window. And it ain't happening.
This isn't a game, Callum!
What else you got?
Don't let the witch put me in the oven!
Come back!
Witch put you in the oven? It's kind of pulsing, like, over here.
I can help you, Callum.
Don't let him take me.
I'm not playing anymore, Callum. Callum, where are you?
Oh, it's this thing. What is this? Pills? Oh, yeah. You know what? We already have to deal with the full terror of a carnival and possess clowns and whatever else. Let's take some drugs, shall we?
These are mine.
Fuck gravity. I can taste your dreams. Not safe. Your mother, say no to graffiti. 1980s. Are you better off than you were 4 years ago? Reagan 80. Some kids laugh and some kids cry, but mostly children simply die. All that you love will be carried away. Something... Bannerman is a fat pig, but his daughter is hot. Destroy reality. Fear the boogeyman. Stop picking your nose then. Don't believe anything they tell you. Well. Oh yeah, this'll... With clowns? This'll be fine. What? What you got there?
Turn around?
Okay. Is that so you can teleport away or? Okay, turn around. I'm going towards the, whatever the hell that is. The Pyramid of Bears? Okay.
Don't touch me.
Who's touching you?
Forgive me, Calum.
Forgive me? Hey, fuck you, clowns. Belly button is the signature of your personal creator. I believe her name was Mama. Every 17th child is a magnet for sinfulness, made omniscient by broken fires in the coastal strain. What the fuck? We don't believe that the earth belongs to battered goats and shamrock afterbirth. Only the truly naked wrens of righteous indignation are severed by war-crossed cleavages in trust. Araclis Ithrithmaya. Beaumont will come to the island. Bearing the talisman, he will shatter the seal that binds the orthodoxy of corruption. Only then will priests shoot, sluts reveal, housewives pontificate, and delay messiahs make dashes for the rescue of Tango and Cash. Sweet the temptress who grips the shaft, twists the shaft, go on, yeah, and descending the third age... Tears into the fourth age darkness while God lie writhing on the shattered face of the earth. Gale has sweetness and grace, but her days are numbered, and heavily flated hives break before frozen wills and silographic actresses in pencil and paper pornography. The all-seeing eye will provide decade-long updates on this story going forward. Okay. Have I played the Impossible Quiz? I have not. I have watched Markiplier play before. All that you love will be carried away. Is the dishwasher leading the way? What are you trying to tell me?
Don't leave me here.
All right, man, I walked a full circle. What do you want out of me?
Mommy, I'm scared.
So that guy's gone now. So now I can leave? Maybe.
Oh, God, no.
Oh, no, I'm turning into a tiger. Gotta get your stripes.
Come back, Caleb.
Hello?
Follow the breadcrumbs.
Follow the breadcrumbs? What breadcrumbs?
The park is a collage of contradictions all of its own. Millions of people die every year in car crashes, and the park has little cars designed specifically to simulate that action. Hear the children scream with joy. In the sideshow alley, you can walk away with 15 cents worth of mass-produced Chinese teddy bears, while a grinning carny pockets your hard-earned $5. And what secrets lie beneath the sullen waters of the lake? The tears of jilted lovers, the soiled condoms of illicit affairs, the clotted blood of the lonely suicide. And the face of the witch looms over it all. I always despised her toothy grin and warty nose. I hate that sparkle in her weathered, watchful eyes. I think Callum is waiting for me. Inside.
Inside what? Alright, so we just left the... We've been to the entrance. Did sideshow. We've done the Tunnel of Tales, the Octotron, the Ferris Wheel, the Bumper Cars, Roller Coaster. All that's left is the House of Horrors.
This isn't a game, Callum!
What are you scared of?
Oh, man. Okay. Let's do it. Oh, no. Are you guys ready for the House of Horrors? The House of Horrors? Yes, exactly. Carrie Killian is Satan's whore. She has a name. Today I learned. Alrighty. Big nose, let's do this. Can you guys see anything? Because I can't see shit. Oh, there we go, it's a loading screen. They're called brothels. This gets its own special loading screen. That's good. That'll be nice. Let me guess. Flashlight time? Flashlight time. And she accepts you into her mouth? Alrighty. So, very little purpose in us looking around. Let's just go forward. And away we go as I look to the sides. Why? Okay, well.
Don't make me look at it.
Atlantic Island Park has closed its gates. A jeerly throng of townfolk gathered as we hung the heavy iron padlock on the gates. Small-minded fools scared of what they don't understand. My machines lie silent and dejected, but I am not beaten. I have sent my wife and son back to Boston, and I have retreated here to the House of Horrors. You must think. Alrighty. Oh. Well, that's nice. Gotta beat the shit out of this kid. Is it mirrors? Don't look. We just go forward. Don't look. Fuck yourself. Thanks. We're in Jinji's world now. Yes. Yes, you are. And there was Medic. Alrighty. Everything's fine. Paper cutouts. I'm good. We got papers. Let's read them. Oh. Okay. Alrighty. This is fine. We're fine. Everything's gonna be...
A resplendent offering.
Hey there, Devlin. How you doing, buddy? You couldn't line that one up any better. So far, so good. I know, Dev, right on point too, actually. Shadow being cast from what and where and how? That's good. Yeah, that's good. It's fine. Uh-huh. Okie dokie. What the fuck is that noise? Oh, well, they're doing some repainting. That's nice. Good. It could use a fresh coat of red. Pardon me, Chief. Just... coming through. Alright, what do you got in here? Anything? Oh, okay, that's good. I don't want to look any further. Appreciate it.
Show yourself!
Huh? left or straight? Left or straight? Anything else in there? No? Oh, we're good. I'm sure it's paint. Yes. Okay, just a light bulb. Just turning on the lights in the attraction. That's all. That little guy needs to pop up, don't you? Hey, there you go. Pop on up. That's good. Okay. I've been down on this level before, haven't I already? Oh. Just a guy running away. That's
Our modest fellowship expands.
Oh my god.
Raise the sum.
Point Ball has resubscribed. Thank you so much, Point. Appreciate it. Praise the sub, everybody. Can we get some praise the suns in chat? Curiosity. One second. Oh, they've disabled my run button. I was gonna go back and check the other. Thank you. Thank you, Devlin. 420 praise it. There you go. Praise the sub. Thanks, point. Got any friends over there with you? No? Okay. That's cool. That's definitely up to code. Guys care about that. We've been closed down. I'm gonna walk around behind the scenes. That's cool. Weird. We don't have a walk cycle. Do we? Oh. It looked like our shadow didn't have a walk cycle there for a second. Going down? Okay, so the doors that are currently locked are going to open up. Oh, my flashlight's giving out. That's that's good. Thanks. Whew. Okay. It's the book Nightmare Circus by Funcom. A circus burns to the ground on opening night, killing dozens. The owner is put to death by an enraged mob of townsfolk. Just as he shouts out a curse, now Raven, a dark-souled wanderer, comes to the ruins at dusk in search of his missing mother. Let the show begin. Oh, that's clever. I don't do baby dolls.
After they let me out, they gave me Callum back and sent me home with a handful of breadcrumbs. Home bit a sweet home. I barely recognized it. Where there had been color and light, there were shadows and regrets. Where there had been warmth, there was a bone-deep coldness that never went away. I tried my hardest to keep the ghosts at bay. Don, watching from the dusty corners while I tried to teach his son to read. My father, coldly assessing me and finding me lacking. I devoted myself to Callum, did the things that they told me. It will get better, they said. Every day will be a little better than the last. I'm in the woods now, lost and afraid. Things never got any better.
Welcome back, Manic. This teddy bear better not fucking jump up. I don't do that shit. A shocking true story. Hunger, the true story of the Donners. On April 16th, 1846, a group of covered wagons began the 2,500-mile journey to California. Just 8 months later, they found themselves stranded in the Sierra Nevada mountains with very little to bite or sup. It has become one of the greatest tragedies of the westward migration the world had ever seen. Now our panel of Donner experts have uncovered compelling evidence that the families were forced to resort to cannibalism in order to survive the terrible winter. In this never-before-seen exposé read about how the Donner children were forced to eat their brothers and sisters in order to survive. All here in the pages of this shocking true story. I love their gingerbread. Mauled by teddy bear. The Wilting. I played that game, what is it? Among the Sleep? Is that it? So you play as a little small child, like a two-year-old, walking around? And it's like a super happy teddy bear at the beginning? Terrifying. With this novel, Susan Anscombe contends her place in one of the most important science fiction writers of a generation. The wilting, a solar flare, has struck the Earth. Millions of people are uprooted from their homes. A young meteorologist searches desperately for a way to stop global overheating. An exotic dancer named Chance O'Hara is the key to saving the world again. Dynamic, exciting, bombastic. Everything we come to expect from an Anscom novel. Chance O'Hara is back, and you better believe she is bigger and better and bolder than ever. Quick, let's solve it. Oh, sad that we can't rotate anything around. That would be a fun little achievement. Solve the Rubik's Cube. I love you, from Callum. That's where I leave my cigarettes, right on the chat's dresser. Pretty tame haunted house so far. Shopping list. Milk, cheese, bread, butter, corn, potatoes, apples, fish sticks. Remember, drop off Callum, electricity bill, fix faucet. Salmon wrench. Can I take the wrench with me? Where'd our flashlight go? Read letter. Miss Malliard, as we agreed on our meeting today, we consider you fully recovered from your illness. This letter is official notification that you considered sound of mind and body and may return to work at any time. Please note that should you discontinue any medication that you have been using, dispose of any remaining medicines. If you feel any time that you're suffering a relapse, then please make contact with a local physician immediately. I wish you continued good health. Dr. Spencer. Okay. Lorraine, I received your letter and I'm quite surprised. You ran off with your father all those years ago and then disappeared off the edge of the map, and then when I finally tracked you down, you refused to answer any of my letters. And now you write me asking for help? I have another family now and another life. Your father was a horrible man and I regret the years that I wasted with him. I loved you, I truly did, but every year you grew more and more like him. You were his girl, never really mine. Still, I would have fought for custody if you hadn't run away with him. It broke my heart, but I needed to go on living. I can't let you back into my life without picking open old wounds. I'm sorry, Lorraine, but I just can't do it. Maybe one day it'll be easier and I can meet Callum. But not yet. I'm not ready to give you. Please don't contact me again. Signed, Karen. Signed, toy. Oh, it's one of those like little bouncy things. Looks like a giant butt plug. Read notice. Dunwich Emergency Services. Lorraine seems to be suffering from depression that began early in her pregnancy. Our discussions have made obvious that these episodes stem from the grief of losing her partner, Don, who died about 6 months ago. There are also several unresolved issues with her father. After being kept under careful observation, we provided standard treatment for this disorder, including electroconvulsion therapy. The patient responded and made a rapid recovery. Aftercare recommendation. Weekly follow-up with a local physician. Mood stabilizers. Lithium-based. Discharge instructions. Lorraine has a newborn son, Callum, who was placed in foster care shortly after birth when Lorraine displayed symptoms of disorientation and depression. It is our judgment that Lorraine is fit to have her son returned to her as long as she follows the recommended aftercare routine and continues with her medication. We have faith that she will be an effective caregiver. Lorraine has her own housing, and her employer, Susie, has said she is welcome to return to her shifts at the diner. Norma Creed, a local woman, has offered to care for Callum while Lorraine works. It is with support network in mind that we feel confident releasing Lorraine from this institution. A prescription for Zoloft that can be filled at Flags Pharmacy in Kingsmouth. She has been advised to start with 50 milligram dose and then, based on the advice of her doctor, to increase the medication as needed. Miss Maillard, an inquiry into the estate of Mr. Donald Williams has been completed. We regret to inform you that the primary beneficiaries of his estate, including the life insurance settlement for accidental death, were listed as Rose Williams and Richard Williams of New York State, deceased parents. Our agency made contact with Mr. and Mrs. Williams and explained your situation, especially as regards the birth of Donald's son, Callum. Unfortunately, they were not receptive to our overtures, and they specified that without any legal proof of a biological relationship, they consider you ineligible to receive any of the monies from Donald's estate. They have asked that we no longer contact them regarding this matter. I understand this may have negative impact on your current financial situation, and I hope that I am not being too forward when I enclose the bill for our services with this letter. Sincerely, Edward Stapleton, your attorney. When did they get Kawasaki in the whole house? Slav nope the fuck out of there. Meow! Oh good, it goes down further. Yay me! Is this some PT shit where I'm gonna do the same thing over and over again? That's the same shit that Callum was saying, but that's a grown-up voice. My curiosity, my run button working? Okay. Door just shut itself. Just gonna rub my ass up against it. Usual strategies. We're just gonna grind the villain. Here we go. You just rub your ass against him. Yeah, baby, you like that, don't you? Okay. There's nothing there. Thank God. That's all I had. Zolift. 100 milligrams. So she's supposed to take half. Okay. Don't fucking do it. I'm talking to you. That's a lot of pill bottles all of a sudden around. Hey, there's that little bastard. Has any of the notes changed, I wonder? Remember, take the pills, follow up with Dr. Spencer, organize babysitter for Callum. Okay, so some of the notes have changed. Wilting. Story of Holdemore. Oh, it's about the true story. Okay, so it's got the actual back covers on them instead of their fake ones that were relating to certain things. Lorraine is back, and you better believe that she's bigger, better, and bolder than ever. Alrighty then. This is the same. Oh, we're going down again? What the f- Close it herself. Paintings have changed. Hat's covered in blood. Looks like there's a demon or something in the car, setting all the woods on fire, setting the car on fire. The doll's missing its head now. Milk, Zola prescription, cheese, Zola prescription, bread, Zola prescription. More pills, tickets to Atlantic Island Park. Just a bunch of wine. I didn't run away. Dad took me. More Zolift. Okie dokie. Maybe. You should probably see a doctor about the effects of Zolift. You guys see that up in the top left hand corner? Something notice. I'm okay with this still, as long as the teddy bear or the dolls don't get out. Easy does it. Does that baby doll have a knife in its hand? That one's got alcohol. That one's made out of pills. What is that one? Alrighty then. Having a party in here, eh? My kind of party. Okay, what's the shopping list look like now? All's a lift. Remember, you are alone. Nobody loves you. Callum is no longer the one he once was. Oh my god, they put the baby in the oven. Bloody ice pick. I don't know. I kinda wanna examine the drawing. Oh, okay. That's what I call a home cooked meal. Alrighty, I guess we're going. A little bit of claustrophobia sitting in there. What the hell is that sound? Well, okay. Feel. Alright, just move forward. Something notice. Do you guys see that? Top left hand corner? Is it the notice? What it, the hell does that mean? Something there too. The word nine? Notice Lorraine, maybe. That's her name. Fucking hell. Teddy bear's gone. Swarm of angry bees has been let loose too in the audio track. Everybody just hanging around. What's in the fridge? Oh, found the teddy bear. We'll keep it closed up in there. You will watch me rot. What the fuck am I doing? Oh, I feel like I'm going crazy. Just circle after circle. Our goal with the game is to drive the player mad. Okay. Library.
Stories are told again and again, and from their shape we build our understanding of the world. Two children are led into the woods. They are lost for a time, but then are captured by an old witch. The child goes missing in Atlantic Island Park. He wanders lost for a time before finding his way into the mouth of an old witch. In the oldest version of this story, the mother and the witch were the same person. I never wanted to be the witch. But I am, aren't I?
So the son got lost in the park, and she's the witch? Wanders into witch's mouth? It's the House of Horrors. And she's the witch, so she has to put the child in the oven? We found a witch! May we burn her? Read page. Kids broke in today. It's been so long since I heard laughter. So very long. I took one of them. I couldn't help myself. It was fast. The others didn't notice. I liked hearing him laugh. This boy from the academy. I put him on a slab. I tickled him until he couldn't breathe. My machines came to life, whirring in time to his gasps and shrieks. I think this is delightful. The change wrought in me by the machine is not yet complete. There must be other children I can lay on my slab. Okie dokie? Eyes without sparkles. Hansel and Gretel. By the Brothers Grimm. I've seen enough hentai to know where this is going. Oh, that's cables. Okay. Oh.
Callum?
How the hell did you fall down like four stairs?
Callum.
Hey there, buddy. Just hanging around? Fuck is that? Drum. The witch took her hands off. She did that on her own will there. That's kind of fucked. Jack Skellington has let himself go.
Hey, Lorraine. Lorraine. Don't blame yourself, Lorraine. People lose things all the time.
So he brought a bee to the interview? Why? Because I'm allergic to bees?
Take a deep breath and think about the last place you saw your son.
On a slab underneath my hands while I had an ice pick in my hand.
In my heart and mind, I always return to Atlantic Island Park.
That was cool. Very, very good. Not as scary. I made it more tense on myself than the game was actually scary. Although the jump scare got me pretty well. It was a good setup. Man, I really enjoyed that. Whew. Oh man, I gotta take the tension down just a little bit. My heart can't take that type of stuff. Whew.